21, Lydia Andrews, her third team fifth. Cougar foul, number 10, Sydney Freeman, her third, team six. Oak Hill foul, 33, Adriana Trexler, her second team foul.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Welcome to the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. My name is Patrick O'Donovan, and I'm a managing director for Raymond James & Associates. So proud to be partners with the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame and the IHSAA to help sponsor and support such a wonderful tournament. We want to acknowledge the hard work and dedication of all of the student athletes participating and playing in today's games, and certainly also acknowledge their coaches, the staff, and trainers for the dedication they've given to help these kids accomplish what they've accomplished. Certainly the children couldn't have gotten here without the love and support of their families, so we want to thank them too. We hope you all enjoy today's broadcast of these games, and happy holidays.
After about a three-hour break, we are back inside of the largest and finest high school field house in the world. It is the evening session of the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. The consolation game between the Patriots of Heritage Hills and the Broncos of Lafayette Jeff. Today's broadcast is presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Stop knocking on wood. By Raymond James, life well planned. And by Encore, don't think senior living, think senior lifestyle. Find out how we are different at liveencore.com. Alongside Pete Smith, I'm Greg Rakestraw. Thanks for joining us here again on the IHSAA Champions Network. And thanks to you watching on MyIndy TV, ISC, and or Comcast 81. Coach, it is always good to be with you. And these are two teams that are trying to avoid an 0-2 day here in Newcastle.
And the third-rated team in the state in both their classes. So Some good games this afternoon, very competitive games, obviously one in overtime. It's going to be a good game tonight, but both of them.
Let's talk about Heritage Hills again. They led for almost the entirety of the second half, just couldn't hold on at the end. And then in overtime, Silver Creek gets them by a score of 82-78. What's your message from Nate Hawkins to his team to get them to 1-1 here today?
Shots will fall. I mean, they just struggled shooting the basketball consistently. They played their rear ends off, and that's going to be a challenge just to get that energy back going tonight. But right now, hang in there. Those shots are going to fall. We've played a really good team this afternoon and darn near won without shooting.
On the flip side, Lafayette, Jeff, they have the tough ask. They played the late game. They have to quickly turn around and play at 6 o'clock. And again, they're not a team that goes very deep. They had to put in a lot of miles to compete with Lawrence Central. How does Mark Barnheiser get his charges just that, recharge for tonight's game?
Well, they'll want to get the tempo going, I think, and play as fast a pace as they can. You say, well, gosh, they're tired. Why would they do that? Well, because that's the way they like to play, and that's the way Coach Barnheiser has coached all his career.
Brooks Barnheiser, 30 points in the loss for Lafayette, Jeff, earlier, their first of the season. Blake Sisley led the way with 24 points and 12 rebounds to the Patriots in their losing effort, their second loss of the season. These two teams fighting for third place in the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. We'll come back with keys, starting lineups, and more as our tip-off is not that far away. You're watching on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Oh, baby, that got me awake. The worm has turned in Logansport.
Look at that play.
The lob underneath, and if you don't get any picture perfect more than that.
That young man will be glad that our cameras were here for tonight's contest.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Ivy Tech provides you with the education you need to jumpstart your career, sometimes in less than a year, for a high-wage, high-demand job. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. With more than 40 locations and online, we are here to help you get started. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu to jumpstart your career.
This is really tough for me because I'm trying to remain professional on the show.
And then you got 50 feet of crap and the New York Knicks. You're 60, so I'm not going to put my hands on you, but I'm going to slap this guy instead.
Are we going to have our first real good argument on this show?
That's what everyone wants to hear.
That is the point.
Oh my God!
We are ripping fast today.
How hard can it be, right?
These are now selling for about $3,500. So we're back to our old ways of pulling rocks.
Act like idiots on camera, open cards, and talk about the hobby.
Game number 3 of 4 today here in Newcastle. The Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, Heritage Hills, and Lafayette Jeff in this consolation game. It is now time for our keys to the game. They are brought to us by Raymond James. And again, for each of these two teams, knocking down threes, a big part of the conversation. But simply put, trying to quickly turn around from losing earlier today.
I think the biggest key, because of the years coaching have been in this situation, the turnaround. Which team's going to have the most energy as they come out to start this game? Second thing, I think rebound is going to be a real big key. Both teams are strong rebounding teams, don't get me wrong. But, you know, it takes a little bit of effort to make sure you block out every time in your second game of the day. And who's going to take care of the basketball? Sometimes consolation games can get really sloppy. I think the team that gets the most shots up is going to be the winner in this game.
Again, our keys to the game brought to us by Raymond James. Time now for our starting lineups presented by Encore. Don't think senior living, think senior lifestyle. Find out how we are different at liveencore.com. Same starting five for both teams today. Heritage Hills. Again, we mentioned the fact that Blake Sisley was their leading scorer with 24 points. It was a very balanced effort. Simon Sherry, Murray Becker was 16 and 17 apiece. But for Sherry, some three-point shooting struggles continuing. He shot 52% from three-point range. Last year, he was 2 of 9 in the morning game.
Yeah, he's had about a four-game stretch here that he's just not shot up to his capabilities. So he's going to try to get out of it today, I'm sure.
On the flip side, Avery Beaver, well, he can commiserate with Mr. Sherry because Avery made just one three. He was 1 of 11 from the floor, 1 of 7 from three-point range. This is after having 36 at LaPel last Saturday.
Yeah, he's a better shooter than that. I look for him to bounce back also.
So the starting five being introduced as we speak for Lafayette, Jeff. They are the home team for a second consecutive game. By the way, let's reference our officials for this evening's contest. Stephen Fruth, Byron Davis, and Chad Beck, our three-man officiating crew. Chad there in the middle. I know that his mom and dad are watching the television broadcast tonight. So hello to Mr. and Mrs. Beck. Thanks for joining us this evening for tonight's contest.
I've had both Chad and Byron work games when I was the head coach, so they got some good ones on this one.
A quick thought about our second game of the evening, the championship match, Silver Creek and Lawrence Central.
LC obviously comes in with playing the toughest schedule, obviously, of the two, but Silver Creek's got a lot of experience in winning that state championship last year. Should be an awesome game.
Silver Creek, a 19-game winning streak, the longest in the state heading into the matchup. Head coaches for tonight's contest, Nate Hawkins, does an outstanding job at Heritage Hills. Had a chance to catch up with him right before tonight's tip-off. And Mark Barnheiser, there you see Mark, scored over 1,800 points in his days at LaPel. Spent time at both Purdue and Auburn as a collegiate basketball player. And won a whole lot of games in the state of Indiana. Of course, was coaching his sons in Alabama before taking the job at Lafayette, Jeff, prior to last season.
Pretty good opportunity there because you could play in junior high also at a high level. So interesting opportunity for them. Good to see Barney back in Indiana coaching again.
Of course, Mark's most successful stint came at Perry Meridian, coaching guys like Andre Owens, Austin Montgomery, and Justin Petty. So Heritage Hills with the basketball. And again, as we have talked about in the earlier game, this is part of their effort to bump up their schedule. Played Bossy this year and beat them December the 10th. Losses to Brownsburg and Silver Creek, and now another 4A competition. And an immediate drive to the basket and score by the leading scorer in program history in Murray Becker.
Well, just an isolation, a half reversal. Cleared the floor at him, and he went with a strong hand. And there's a strong hand drive for layup right there.
And an easy look for Brooks Barnheiser. And he averages 19 a game, had 30. The most he has had in a Lafayette Jeff uniform. He is a junior. Butler has offered him amongst others. Sherry gets the first to go, and again, you got to think that will get the confidence going.
He could have 30 tonight. He really could if he bounces out of that just kind of slump he's had right now, Greg.
His father, the superintendent of Heritage Hills School Corporation. Catch and shoot three by Beaver. Not that time. And Sherry did a lot of other things well in the loss today. He had 6 rebounds, 4 assists, 3 steals, and 2 blocks. Now Sisley going to work. Left the jump hook short. Johnson ball kicked by a Lafayette Jeff player.
You know, Jeff played more players than they normally do in that first game today. They usually only play 5 to 6. Barney's never been a real guy to rotate guys in his style. So if you can start for him, you're going to get a lot of minutes. That's going to be a key here, as we said, as to, you know, turnover-wise. Turnover round, I should say, who's going to be able to get going here.
And a force that one and a turnover. Barnheiser. Another easy look.
You know, Greg, I'm a Northern Indiana guy, and I remember Mark when he was at Purdue before he went to Auburn, and Brooks really has that same build Mark did.
Well, Sigler for 3. Not that time. He went 1 of 4, all from three-point range in the morning game. One thing that Heritage Hills did very well, offensive rebound in the morning contest, and on cue, they have 3 on this trip. They won't get a 4th.
No, but you're right. They outworked Silver Creek on the boards that first game tremendously.
19 offensive rebounds in the loss this morning. Beaver for 3. And if he gets that open of a look, that's a problem for Heritage Hills. He's had 2 good looks so far. One of them has been able to fall.
I think this is just going to be an up-and-down game, Greg. I mean, like, both teams are just going to try to score and outscore and outscore. Should be a fun one to watch, fans.
Sisley. Let's make sure Jones is all right. He's kind of grabbing at that left knee. So he will be exiting as Armani Williams will check in. And again, that is a matchup issue for Lafayette Jeff, because Jones at 6'7", 300 pounds, that's a difference maker, especially offensively. Now a much smaller look for Lafayette Jeff. Williams had 2 points in the loss earlier. Barnheiser will let it fire from anywhere in the building. Beaver is camping out there waiting. And that is like a free throw for that young man.
Boy, they got to get a hand on his face. That's too wide open for Avery Beaver.
Came in as a 52% three-point shooter on the season. That number has dropped based on going 1 of 7 versus the smothering defense of Lawrence Central. Three in the corner is good for Jake Johnson. But Jake Johnson gets it to go. Johnson was 3 of 9 from the floor to get 11 points in the loss earlier today.
That's going up.
Let's a man fly by. Takes his time. Misses that one. Rebound corralled by Johnson. Johnson rebounds very well for a guard. Becker.
Boom.
Has kind of an old school game. Has a nice mid-range game. He's got 4. His dad played at Valparaiso University. And that one's short. And Sisley runs the floor so well for a big guy. And a blocking foul going to be called against Braxton Barnheiser.
Pretty torrid pace for two teams that just played earlier today, but that's the way they like to play. I think we'll get a lot of shots up. Should be a lot of points. Just a little bit late, didn't get his foot out of bounds to cut that baseline off. Block call. Good help, though, by Braxton. He just made the steal, basically.
Second turnover by Heritage Hills. And Barnheiser misses the first one at the rim, does not miss the second one. And while he was certainly outstanding from three-point range, he's been all around the 10 so far for Lafayette Jeff.
You know, with Armani Williams in there for Jeff now, they can play a much faster pace. That is one good thing. Now, here's going to be the matchup right there, and that's where he's going to really struggle, I think, trying to guard Blake Sisley.
And immediately Armani Williams whistled for a foul. Again, both Barnheisers go 6'6", but they are wing 6'6 players, not post 6'6 players. Becker. Kind of changed his mind in midair. Third Patriot turnover.
Nice pass. Oh, boy. Had a great look there. Ashton Beaver just couldn't catch that pass. But Braxton Barnheiser with an outstanding look on the break.
Both these teams did a good job of limiting turnovers in their first game of the day. Heritage Hills had just 7. Lafayette Jeff had 8. But you expect a little mental fatigue will kind of start to play into that number tonight. Good read by Barnheiser. And able to get the save. To that point, Heritage Hills already with 4 turnovers in the first 4 minutes. Avery Beaver just waiting. Same result. Third made 3 of this game.
They got to get him to get out of his comfort zone.
As in move him off that spot?
Yeah. Run him off the line. Bump him a little bit. Get him out of that comfort zone.
3 threes for Beaver. 3 twos for Barnheiser. Another 3 by Sisley. First of this game. He made 2 late in the game against Silver Creek.
In the last 2 possessions, they've really tried to get the ball to him. 1 was on a turnover. That time he got it at the top of the key for the easy 3.
As expected, this has been quite the jump shooting exhibition between these two teams so far. And a rapidly moving first
nice.
Game. Great backdoor cut. Barnheiser to Barnheiser. Brooks the basket. Braxton the assist.
I think they've been doing that since junior high days, probably. Good read there.
You may go beyond that one, to be honest with you. Sisley looking to go to work. Nice up and under.
Yeah, they put the taller. They put Brooks Barnheiser on him that time. Moved Williams over to a different player there, but didn't matter. Sisley scored.
Sisley was 7 to pace the Heritage Hills attack, and both teams living up to their offensive prowess. 78 points a game this year for Lafayette Jeff. 77 for the Patriots. Beaver, different side, different result. Good crash, but stepping out of bounds after getting the rebound was Johnson. Good thing that whistle blew. It prevents an easy layup for Lafayette Jeff. And that leads us to our media timeout. 2:34 left to play in the opening quarter. 17 apiece in the consolation game of the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic here on the IHSAA Champions Network. Presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Tired of watching the same old things on TV? Something new is on the horizon. The ISC Sports Network. Contact your cable provider today to add the ISC Sports Network. See the big games, the big moments, the championships, and more from all across the state. High schools, colleges, original content you can't find anywhere else. On the ISC Sports Network, it's all here. Find out more information at iscsportsnetwork.com. Today's game presented in part by the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame, honoring, preserving, and promoting the heritage of Indiana high school basketball. The Hammerhead Homies may have their own exhibit at the Hall of Fame by the end of the day. They have been part of the conversation here at Newcastle all day long.
They have their own Twitter handle, don't they?
Hammerhead Homie. Braxton Barnheiser couldn't get that to go. Good weak side glass by Sherry. Both their guards do an excellent job of rebounding the basketball through the Patriots. Becker. Again, loves that 15 to 18 foot jump shot. By the way, that's Wes, Noah, Gavin, and Nick in the Shark outfits behind the Heritage Hills bench. Barnheiser's pass got deflected by the backboard. Second Jeff giveaway. And nobody stopped the ball.
Oh. Cardinal sin there.
Right down Route 1 for Johnson. We're in Newcastle. Probably should say State Road 3 is the better way to describe that. Deep three, Barnheiser, no. And Sisley with one hand snares the rebound. And off to the races goes Heritage Hills. Sigler tied up by Barnheiser. And the arrow will give it to Lafayette Jeff. First substitution, Caden Kratzer had the only bench points for Heritage Hills earlier. Hit a three. 5'10 senior, averages 5 points a contest. Sigler sits. He was the Mental Attitude Award winner in Class 3A football. Heritage Hills, the runners-up to Bishop Chatard in the state championship game 4 weeks ago. Ashton Beaver, step back three. He made a three earlier. He's got one now in this game. The Still Beaver brothers have combined for four threes.
Sorry. No one is finding out where the basketball is at for Jeff defensively. Lucked out there. I think their confusion caused Heritage Hills to be confused on offense.
Sometimes you can be too open. That can be a problem. This Lafayette Jeff team won the Franciscan Health Hoops Classic. Third consecutive year they have won the tournament played at the Crawley Center right after Thanksgiving. Of course, members of the North Central Conference. Three for Beaver does not go, and Sisley the uncontested rebound.
Last two shots that the Beaver shot have been a little bit farther than what his first three were that he made. A little farther out in the court.
Sisley the runner. Nine for Sisley. Stops have been at a premium so far, or few and far between. Backdoor cut. Good read by Becker. And the steal by the senior.
Right in front of the Hills bench. That helped. They were calling the backdoor out if you couldn't hear it on the air.
Nate Hawkins tells his players, let's hold for one, fellas. Here is Sherry, young man that's going to play baseball at the University of Evansville next year. Make the short trip from northern Spencer County. The runner off the window. And the inbounds pass, the inbounder stepped on the baseline. So another free look here for the Patriots.
Back pick for Sisley.
A 25-point first quarter. Could be two or three more.
Back pick for Sisley. Oh, he didn't take it. He stood after the three instead.
Kratzer for three. Almost got it. Heritage Hills trying to get a split today in Newcastle before a long bus trip home. 25-20. They lead Lafayette Jeff. the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Hi, I'm Matt Wolford, president of the IHSAA Foundation, and we need your help. We need your help so the youth of our community can develop advanced leadership skills. We need your help giving high school administrators and coaches the instruction and insight they need to be better role models and teachers. To learn more or to make a tax-deductible contribution, go to IHSAAFoundation.org. You'll not only be contributing to the foundation of the IHSAA, you'll be contributing to the foundation of our community.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Ivy Tech provides you with the education you need to jumpstart your career, sometimes in less than a year, for a high-wage, high-demand job. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. With more than 40 locations and online, we are here to help you get started. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu to jumpstart your career.
Becoming a licensed sports official is a great way to make a positive difference in the community and support the over 160,000 Indiana student athletes that participate across 22 IHSAA sports. Sports officiating allows you to stay connected to the game, become a role model for our young student athletes, earn extra money, and support the patrons and communities of our IHSAA member schools. To learn more about becoming a licensed IHSAA official, log on to ihsaa.org/officials today.
Second quarter action about to get underway here in Newcastle. It's presented in part by Franciscan Health. At Franciscan, our team is dedicated to being the region sports injury champ, specializing in treatment, rehab, and the most comprehensive concussion management available. Franciscan Health Sports Medicine, inspiring health. And Lafayette Jeff's offense just inspired a backdoor cut by Heritage Hills.
That was way too easy.
Eight for Becker. Beaver from the elbow. A rare two-point field goal. In fact, his first of the day. He's made four threes in the first five quarters. Adam Guth is in there for the first time for Heritage Hills. Gives Sisley a break. Becker finds him, and Guth misses. Guth averages less than a point a game. He's a 6'2 junior. Barnheiser, little double clutch in midair,
trying to draw the defender to him, and he couldn't, so he kind of got caught in no man's land, had to shoot that one. This is a great pace for Heritage Hills right now. They're getting a shot up about every 5 seconds to 7 seconds down the floor, and that leads into their hands because Jeff just says no depth that they play with.
Trailer three by Barnheiser is an air ball. Heritage Hills will walk this one up just to kind of catch a bit of a breather. Johnson had 11 in this morning's game. He averages. It's under 7 points of contest. Another backdoor cut. Sherry able to get it up, but not in the basket. Good to see that Matt Jones is going to come back now for Lafayette Jeff. And with that, Sisley back in for Heritage Hills. Also, Jacob Collicott in for the first time for Lafayette Jeff. He had 2 points and a nice reverse layup in the loss against Lawrence Central earlier. Becker off the screen.
Good patience, real good patience. Found him right there.
Sisley had it poked away. Heritage Hills has matched their turnovers from 36 minutes against Silver Creek in 10 minutes of this game. And then Jeff proceeds to give it right back.
Yeah, that's what kept him in that Silver Creek game, between that and how hard they rebounded.
Already the kind of walking the ball up the floor just to give yourself a bit of an extra breather here. Again, Sisley can knock that down
to him.
He's got a dozen. Could be playing his way out of the all-tournament team. The 6'9 junior, 20 points, 8 rebounds a contest. Beaver for three. Not that time. And Sigler able to snare the rebound. Becker from the elbow.
That's great action. When you can drive the ball to the center of Main Street, which I call the middle of the floor, you've either got the back cut, which he didn't use that time, but they've used twice successfully here already in the game. And if he's not guarded well, he's got the open shot.
Jones, touch last by Sisley. And Jones had 7 points. He got great looks against LC. Just had a tough time finishing. He went 3 of 11 from the floor in the afternoon game. Jones averages 10 points and 4.5 rebounds a game.
He's come a long way. 2 years ago, my last year at Garen, we always played Lafayette Jeff. And he was on the JV team and just learning how to play back then. Like you said, had a good afternoon game, actually.
He is a difference maker, is Jones. A great counterbalance to the 4 3-point shooters that spread the floor for the Broncos. Speaking of 3-point shooters, Barnheiser a bit short on that one.
Well, the legs are starting to look like they're a little tired, obviously, which means the pace needs to pick it up for Heritage Hills to kind of take advantage of that. And Jeff needs to probably get a little bit closer. That was a little bit deep right now for this late, you know, this late in the day after playing a game and a half almost.
Well, Barnheiser takes a break for Lafayette Jeff, which is something he did not do this morning. He played all 32 minutes, as did Braxton Barnheiser, as did Avery Beaver. This Lafayette Jeff team kind of hit their average in terms of threes with 9, but it took them 27 attempts to get to that point. They normally are a 47% shooting outfit from three-point range. Becker, the runner, no. But Sigler is there for the putback. Good seal by Sisley to make it an easy look for Cole Sigler. And it's a double-figure lead for the first time. Jones runs the floor. Blocking foul and one for Jones. Jones gets his first basket.
Yeah, Kratzer a little bit late on the attempt to take the charge. I'm not sure I would take a charge. When I see someone that is that big of a center, I think I would have kind of got out of the way there. And he tried to a little bit too late.
Enjoying today's game. Help make sure the resources are available so that great games like these can be played forever by supporting the IHSAA Foundation. Go to IHSAAFoundation.org and make a tax-free contribution today. Jones hits the free throw. He was 1 of 2 in the morning session. Sisley, a little pick and pop. Good look that would not go. He's already made 2.
What a nice luxury when you got a 6'8", 6'9", perimeter player that can score around the basket, which he does a lot, but also can shoot very consistently from 3.
Barnheiser, again, he'll let it fly and have no problem knocking that down for his first basket of the game.
He just came in off the bench, and I think maybe a little bit of break helped his legs. He shot an air ball earlier just like his brother did.
Back to a 4-point game. And a steal. 3-v-1. Barnheiser, Beaver, basket, and
block.
One. Count the basket. Or are they going to call that an offensive foul?
No, block.
Yep, good basket blocking foul on Heritage Hills.
Now I could tell he was way underneath the basket.
Agreed.
When he tried to take it. Look how deep he is. And the idea was right, but you can't land out of bounds and draw a charging foul.
Well, I was kind of reading the reaction of Heritage Hills, and I thought when they saw a good basket signal, I thought they thought it was a charge that was signaled. I agree, that was the proper call. So Beaver rattles home the free throw. He is 14 of 15 on the season from the line, and a 9-point spurt for Lafayette Jeff. They have gotten 3 points each of their last 3 trips. Trying to answer with a 3 for Heritage Hills, does not go.
Boy, great block out there.
Ashton Beaver looking at a pass for Barnheiser, stripped by Kratzer. It'll remain Lafayette Jeff ball.
Boy, it's a little bit different than the first quarter, Greg. That first quarter, the Patriots were the ones that were getting the runouts. Right now it's Jeff.
And that will lead us to our media timeout. So 9 consecutive points for the Broncos. Heritage Hills' lead is down to 1. The Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic from Newcastle on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
Sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think, maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Inspired by your nerves of steel and the nerves and joints that help our bodies go. Inspired by your return to battle and vanquishing your hand and wrist pain. inspired by longer walks and breakthrough joint replacements that keep you in step. We're inspired to deliver the best in orthopedic care because at Franciscan Health, we're inspired by you.
The only way to get better is to challenge yourself. And that's what we're doing at Xfinity. We are challenging ourselves to improve every aspect of your experience. And this includes our commitment to being on time, every time. That's why if we're ever late for an appointment, we'll credit your account $20. It's our promise to you. We're doing everything we can to give you the best experience possible. Because we should fit into your life, not the other way around.
Today's game presented in part by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. You're good at being you. You've been you for years. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance is good at your insurance. Find an agent to help you think about it at infb.com. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood. Greg Rakestraw, Pete Smith with you. 9 straight points. Could it be 12? Yep. Beavers got 17.
Great play out of the timeout. Double screen off the baseline. Got Beaver a good look. You know, he hit his first three starting the game, and now he's getting back into the groove again.
It does not take long for Jeff to catch up on you because they score points in bunches. 12 in their last 4 trips. 2 threes, 2 old school threes. Speaking of old school, little Mike and drill by Sisley, the lefty half hook.
Yeah, good inside out play.
34 apiece between two of the top scoring teams in the state. Barnheiser, no. And who touched it last? Ruled that Sisley did.
Boy, Braxton's had some good looks, just hadn't been able to fall. You know, most of this run has been without Brooks Barnheiser on the court. He changed just a little bit offensively. The Beavers look for their shots a little bit more, probably.
Collicott, ball deflected, throws it away.
Not a fan of the baseline pass. It's a tough one to make.
Trying to isolate Sisley against Jones. It's a quick double and a reach-in foul coming against Avery Beaver. Been a relatively whistle-free game. That's just the 5th foul called combined on these two teams.
At times we have a torrid pace, and at times it's kind of like a snail's pace.
At times the fact these guys play today has caught up with them.
Absolutely.
Of course, point. An overtime game for Heritage Hills. Again, they were the morning game. Sisley stripped, lost it. And Collicott then gives it right back.
He did. Kind of got no man's land. That's a bad place to pick the ball up, about 35 feet away from the basket.
I think somebody pointed out that turnovers might be a factor in this game, like they've coached for 35 years or something. So Brooks Barnheiser back in, but 15 combined turnovers between these two teams that both average almost that number on a combined game per game basis.
The good part about this, Greg, both teams are really playing hard.
Yep.
And I've seen consolation games where teams just didn't really want to be here. Both these teams are playing very, very hard.
Becker, again, mid-range. Got it to go.
Great screen, too, on that play.
His game is very similar of what Jacoby's game is for Silver Creek. Loves kind of finding those open spaces middle of the half-court set.
Brooks Barnheiser checked in at that last dead ball from Jeff.
Placed Matt Jones. Again, Jeff goes a bit smaller. Beaver just inside the 3-point line. He's got 5. Averages 3.5 a contest. He is the younger of the Beaver brothers. Steal by Lafayette Jeff. Avery finds Braxton. Barnheiser's got 5. And Lafayette Jeff seesaws back in front, 38-36.
Both teams just played half-court man this entire game, basically. No zones or no special defensive so far. Just trying to outscore each other. Good luck. Cleared the help side. Avery Beaver just a little bit late on the help. He saw it coming, but at 6'9", he's a tough one to kind of low clamp on that catch. Couldn't do it.
Sisley's got 16 in this half. He's got 40 for the day. Drive and kick. 3 in the corner for Collicott. Does not go. And Becker, the rebound for Heritage Hills.
Let's see if they wait for the last shot here. I think Avery Beaver's not going to guard him too tight. Say, if you want to do that, we'll go in pretty close at halftime.
Lafayette Jeff does have the basketball to begin the third quarter.
Jeff does have fouls to give here, too. If they start to get beat on a drive, it's not going to put them at the line. The Patriots won't be shooting free throws.
Heritage Hills led by as many as 10.
Yep, good seal. Tough angle in the pass, though.
Good read by Barnheiser, but he stepped on the baseline, so no turnover there.
Simon makes one more pass that right wing to Sigler. Then he's got a nice look in there. That's a tough pass from that top of the key.
So 5 seconds to work with here.
America's play.
Sherry, turn
short.
And fire.
Short, yeah.
And could not get it to go. 38-all is our score at halftime in this consolation game between Heritage Hills and Lafayette Jeff. Stay tuned. The halftime show comes your way next as you're watching the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
The Pacers want you to feel the excitement and be a part of the action. Plan your company, school, or team outing today. As a group, you can play where the pros play. Perform in front of thousands. Pump up the crowd. High five the stars. Bring the noise. Dance your heart out. Take home a part of the game. Great experiences are available for your group. Go to pacers.com/groups.
Becoming a licensed sports official is a great way to make a positive difference in the community and support the over 160,000 Indiana student-athletes that participate across 22 IHSAA sports. Sports officiating allows you to stay connected to the game, become a role model for our young student-athletes, earn extra money, and support the patrons and communities of our IHSAA member schools. To learn more about becoming a licensed IHSAA official, log on to ihsaa.org/officials today.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to IHSAATV.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
Halftime here in Newcastle. Welcome back to the consolation game of the 2019 Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic, 38-38. Heritage Hills and Lafayette Jeff tied at halftime. We always have a special guest that joins us at halftime of these games. We're joined now by Damian Magos. He is the Managing Director of Public Finance for Raymond James. Damian, thank you so much for your time and for your support of this event. Why is this event such a perfect fit for Raymond James?
It is. Raymond James is the largest underwriting firm in Indiana, specializing not only in with personal finance, but also with school finance. And I have been personally involved with school financing, K-12 financing throughout the state for about 30 years now. And so it's just we're very proud sponsors just to be associated with this type of organization.
Again, it's fantastic to have you, and obviously Raymond James is a nationally, if not internationally, known firm.
Right.
What makes Raymond James in Indiana unique, special, or different?
The footprint. We are not only, like I said, we are the largest underwriting firm, and not only in Indianapolis or Fort Wayne, or there are 80 locations or offices throughout the state. So
yep.
it's a big distribution area, kind of that grassroots. We have offices in almost every town in Indiana.
I'm going to say 80 locations, 92 counties. I'd say
have exactly
the state map covered. What's it been like to be here watching basketball all day long?
Oh, it's great. This is something that I have been involved with over the years for a very long time, and it's an absolute great event, great teams out here. Absolutely love it. Last night, with the girls' teams, and then all day today with the boys, just been wonderful.
All right, I see you've got a Butler fan here with you this evening.
I do.
That's right behind us off camera.
Yeah.
Who's this guy?
This is my grandson, Luca.
All right, well, I'm glad that Luca has had a good time. Damian, thank you so much for joining
absolutely.
Us. And more importantly, thank you so much for your support of high school athletics with the good folks at Raymond James.
We appreciate it. Thank you.
Again, joining us is Damian Magos. Again, he is the public managing director for public finance here Raymond James. Again, joining us here, they're the presenting sponsor of the Hall of Fame Classic. Our score at the break, 38 apiece between Lafayette Jeff and Heritage Hills. We're back in just a moment as you're watching on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
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 Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Great answer by Lafayette.
Takes home the victory.
Taking down the record.
Throws it deep. He's got a man and is taking it.
Trying to find a lane. Walker has hit his second home run of the tournament.
And it's going to be a touchdown.
This is the dawn of an old day. Because AT&T and DirecTV are offering yesterday's technology today. TV from space. As long as it's not too rainy, or windy, or there isn't a branch in the way.
Branchy.
Welcome to the moment no one's been waiting for.
The fastest internet and the best TV experience is already here with X1, only from Xfinity.
Tonight's game from Newcastle, presented in part by Indy Card Exchange, located on the north side of Indianapolis, next to North Central High School, just off of Westfield Boulevard and just south of 86th Street. Follow them at Ball Card Exchange, X-Change, on Twitter and Instagram, or log on to IndyCardExchange.com for latest details and information. And, of course, catch the Andy and Bruno Show each month on the ISC Sports Network. Greg Rakestraw, two-time state championship-winning coach Pete Smith, with me on the broadcast this evening on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. And I would think, Pete, the first half kind of played out almost exactly as we thought it would. Two very good offensive teams.
Yeah, defensively, you know, this definitely is not going to be a game that coaches love defensively. You know, it's tough to get them to rally to play a second game in one day and concentrate any kind of defense. But at that same time, you know, Jeff got several backdoored times defensively, and you know, gave Heritage Hills a great start, but then second quarter, Jeff really came back.
17 of 29, the Patriots in the first half, 4 of 9 from three-point range, 16 for Sisley, 10 for Becker. They were a combined 12 of 16 from the floor. For Lafayette, Jeff, the big difference from the earlier game, obviously the play of Avery Beaver, had just 3 points on 1 of 11 shooting versus Lawrence Central. He was 6 of 10 and 4 of 8 from three-point range. I think the great news for Lafayette, Jeff, is that you're tied, and it was not the typical half from Braxton Barnheiser. He was 2 of 8 and just 1 of 5 from three-point range.
Yeah, not his normal game. He started out, he drained his first shot, and then he's short on everything else. So don't know if there's a little bit of fatigue right there. I'd like to give some claim that it was Heritage Hills defense, being a guy that did like to coach defense a little bit when I coached. But
all right, so let's also thank our friends from Ivy Tech Community College, one of our great sponsors here on the ISC Sports Network. Learn more about the most affordable way to earn your college degree and start a high-paying career, whether it means a one-year certificate or doing the first 2 years at Ivy Tech and transferring to a four-year institution. This is the place for you. Check out ivytech.edu. Great to get some of the Shanahan family on the broadcast there. Not to mention our friend Adam Hamby, the land of many courts. Great to have them on board our coverage from the Forum Tip-Off Classic at Southport a couple of weeks ago. They've got their wares on display here at the Hall of Fame in tonight's contest. What do you hope to see differently, if anything at all, in half number two, Pete?
Well, I would think both teams are going to talk a little bit more about stopping the basketball. Jeff gave up a couple easy layups early, and that got Heritage Hills going a little bit. That being said, I think Heritage Hills will get the ball inside again to Sisley as often as possible, just because of a higher percentage shot. But, you know, they drove a lot, as you'll see in our highlight clip right now. That was Becker with an easy break early in the game, easy drive.
You know, Heritage Hills, 29 field goal attempts, 9 from three-point range. Pretty good balance there. Lafayette Jeff was very three-dependent, which is not surprising. 30 field goal attempts, Pete, 18 from outside the arc.
True, and something we said, you know, in the pregame, Simon Sherry has not been shooting the ball very well. A very quiet first half again for him, and just not typical of him to only have 5 points at halftime, the senior standout point guard.
At some point in time, though, you just got a feeling that'll click, and the good news is for him, he's still doing so many other things well for this basketball team.
Oh, he's a great leader, great floor general leader, no doubt about it.
Again, a Beaver three-pointer. He's got four of the six makes from three-point range for the Broncos so far. Braxton Barnheiser has one. Ashton Beaver has one of those as well. So both teams now back on the floor and getting ready for the third quarter of action. And last year, this event won by Warren Central. Lawrence Central playing Silver Creek in our upcoming championship game. And a reminder, today's game is being broadcast on the ISC Sports Network. Stay connected to the ISC all season long by downloading the ISC app from your favorite app stores and watch the games live or from the archives. The ISC Sports Network, local, lives here. Al Gooden leading Lawrence Central into that championship game. Former state championship winning coach at Harding High School. Brandon Hoffman, his opposite number from Silver Creek. Of course, he too a state championship winning coach about 9 months ago at Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
You know, originally I wasn't sure how Al would do, quite frankly, coming down from Fort Wayne. And boy, he just, when I say that, he was ingrained in that Fort Wayne
right.
community. Outstanding player at Fort Wayne when he played in high school. Great Ball State player. Had such great things going when he was in Fort Wayne, Harding, and then New Haven. But boy, he has just taken that Lawrence Central program and with some really good players and has really got them to mesh. There's been years LC had really good players and just didn't mesh. They're meshing very well again this year, number one or number two in the state right now.
LC last played in this game 4 years ago and won the Hall of Fame Classic. You can only play in this event once every 4 years because you get two extra games for playing in this tournament. On the flare. And baseline to baseline pass, but doesn't work.
I'm not a big fan of that baseline pass. Anybody that watched the first half heard me say that one time. It's just a tough pass because your defensive flow is moving towards the baseline. If it's not wide open, you got to be on a pinpoint, and you're also landlocked.
Eight turnovers now for Jeff, 11 for Heritage Hills.
Yeah, that's a biggie. We said turnovers in the pregame. Team that gets the most shot up is going to win because they're going to shoot it. They're going to get a lot of shots up, but do you get more than the other team?
By the way, fouls were a factor for both these teams in the morning game. Not in this one. There were hardly any fouls in half number one.
It's the most patient either team had in the first half.
Johnson corner three. And he's their fifth leading scorer, but he's a more than capable shooter.
Well, he is. When you can penetrate and get him open, he's a very good standing shooter. I noticed that this morning also.
Johnson and Sisley, the two juniors of the starting five for Heritage Hills. Johnson's got eight. He's had a solid day today. And Barnheiser trying to get on track.
Good luck.
Feed. And Jones with two field goals.
Yeah, very good look. Jones a little slowed in the first half by an injury that kept him on the bench for a while, but seems to be going at full strength now.
And Becker, and he generates a lot of their offense. Sigler for three. Sigler with 1 2-point field goal in the first half.
Looked a lot bigger in pads that state finals game you and I were at.
Outstanding year for Heritage Hills in football. Undefeated until that championship game. Barnheiser got fouled, late whistle, but whistle blown nonetheless. And free throws, two of them for Barnheiser. And Barnheiser about to shoot free throws 3 and 4 of this game. Heritage Hills has yet to attempt a free throw. Today's game presented in part by In the Gym Hoops with over 28,000 followers on YouTube. In the Gym Hoops can get your son or daughter the exposure they need to take their game to the next level. Follow on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram for more information. Live in the gym, get results. And yes, Barnheiser is nowhere close to the free throw line as he shoots that free throw.
Sometimes known as unorthodox a little bit, but boy, the kid can really score. He plays really, really hard.
He averages 19 a game. He was just 4 of 16 from the floor in the morning session. He has 7 points tonight.
the senior of the two Barnheiser brothers.
Good double by Brooks Barnheiser, but the carom goes the way of Heritage Hills, and Sisley with the flush. Sisley now with 18. Three-man weave action. Right idea. Good hands by Sherry. We're talking about the little things that Sherry does well. 18 points, even if the jump shot's been a little askew lately. Five boards, seven assists, four steals a game.
Yeah, he does it all for him, leadership-wise particularly. Good look. Oh, good movement. Had a shot there. Passed up on it. Yeah, Becker's done a really nice job on Brooks Barnheiser, one-on-one-wise tonight, as you see that matchup here.
Barnheiser forced the issue and stepped on the sidelines.
Yep. I think he's getting a little frustrated. When I say that, Becker's just been on him every time he's been on the catch.
Becker at 6'4", Brooks Barnheiser at 6'6".
Isolation here. There you go.
Deep three by Sherry, not that time. He made his first one. He's only made one field goal since, and then trying to make the play, commits a foul. But again, fouls have been at such a minimum. That's the first foul of this half, and it comes 3 minutes and 10 seconds in. Barnheiser finds a little bit of room.
And I think it just rolled off his hand. I think he thought there was enough body contact there that he was going to draw a foul. And
Sisley had him straight up. Sisley, the short corner baseline jump shot does not go. Beaver. Not that time. No,
he was calling for it, too. He wanted Braxton to throw that ball to him as quick as he could. He was open.
There's that backdoor cut that, again, Barnheiser started to figure out that cut just a little bit more.
Both teams are really looking fatigued here at the start of the third quarter, getting back on defense, but their passes are getting a little sloppy also, so they can't take advantage of the tiredness or weariness of their defensive play there.
Sigler, good take. His second basket. Senior averages 10.5 points a game. I remember that football team on the basketball program, but fortunately he's injured and currently out in Doyle. A three-sport athlete at Heritage Hills. And that three is good for Ashton Beaver. Beaver's got eight.
Hadn't missed a shot yet.
That would be Mark Doyle for the Patriots. He's about 6'4 and 300 pounds.
He's a big boy.
Sisley for three, not that time. Barnheiser, look ahead pass, brother to brother.
Yeah, good run out there.
Braxton to Brooks. And the Broncos in front by a basket. Inside out play, Johnson yet again. His third made three. He's been in double figures both games. Deep three,
got it.
I used this line earlier. Some of his shots should count for four. Good drive. And squaring it off the window is Sherry, his first point since halftime. 50-50.
Yeah, Matt Jones wanted to move out and help on the baseline, but I think right now he's limping a little bit with that bad wheel he had in the first quarter. Yet size-wise, he needs to be in there to battle Sisley as much as he can for the Broncos. Good back cut.
Another good feed. Barnheiser's got 12. 16 assists a game for Lafayette Jeff. Over 20 for Heritage Hills. Two teams that share the basketball. Looking for another one was Johnson. And Sisley got fouled. I'm going to say on the floor, so no shot, but that will lead us to then our media timeout. Foul will go against Jones. 2:24 to play in the third quarter. Our score. Broncos lead by two. Consolation game of the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. And you're watching on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. We're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping the gas pump on a double zero.
You ever get no Donovan Garlits?
I know Donovan, yeah.
We're
how's he doing?
Yeah.
Is he still at Greencastle?
He
says, man, you look good
sandwiches.
And sound good on TV. Deadly combo.
Is he still at Greencastle?
Yes, assistant superintendent.
Tell him I said hello.
Yeah.
So start with Indiana Farm.
The coaching fraternity misses him.
Stop.
But.
Knocking on wood.
I've always liked Indianapolis. I've been interested in the bigger city life. The community and everything fell into place.
With my degree, I plan on becoming a pediatric nurse. Indianapolis has several hospitals and different options to choose from as to where I should go.
I chose Indianapolis because I love the Pacers, I love the Colts, and this is a basketball city. Just wanted to stay in the city, play in front of my friends and family, and try to give Marion my best.
Hi, I'm Matt Wolford, president of the IHSAA Foundation, and we need your help. We need your help so the youth of our community can develop advanced leadership skills. We need your help giving high school administrators and coaches the instruction and insight they need to be better role models and teachers. To learn more or to make a tax-deductible contribution, go to IHSAAFoundation.org. You'll not only be contributing to the foundation of the IHSAA, you'll be contributing to the foundation of our community.
Today's game presented in part by the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame, honoring, preserving, and promoting the heritage of Indiana high school basketball. Greg Rakestraw, Pete Smith with you here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Sherry, not that time. He's made just one of those so far in tonight's game. Set the school record for three-point percentage in a season last year at 52.5%. Barnheiser, the runner.
Nice, like that old style basketball. Little runner with a hook shot.
Each of the brothers Barnheiser with a dozen. Little half-court trap look here by Lafayette, Jeff.
The first change in any kind of defense basically in the whole game.
And a steal.
And it paid off.
And Braxton will lay it up and in. And now a timeout going to be taken by Heritage Hills. It is a full timeout. We'll keep it right here. Today's game presented in part by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. You're good at being you. You've been you for years. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance is good at your insurance. Find an agent to help you think about it at infb.com. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Good look at Coach Hawkins.
So Lafayette Jeff has stretched that lead up to six.
Yeah, they came out of the timeout, as you mentioned, in a trap. This was a nice drive to come out of the timeout. Probably a set play, and then defensively came down, caused the turnover there. Braxton Barnheiser gets another run out. And right away, Coach Hawkins doesn't want this to slip away. 1:48 to go in the third. Tired legs by both teams. You want to stay as close as you can.
You reference Coach Hawkins, formerly at Forest Park High School before taking the job at Heritage Hills, trying to lead these Patriots to their first sectional championship since 2003. Frankly, they've got much bigger aspirations than that, but first things first, you got to get by Bossy and some other good teams in Southwest Indiana.
They're the number three rated team in the state in 3A, and obviously getting the opportunity and honor to play here says they have the capabilities of it. I think they do. I think, you know, like we talked about, Simon Sherry, their point guard, is a better shooter than what he's been playing lately, and he'll get that back.
Little half-court trap here by Jeff. Johnson steps in and takes the 15-footer. Do not tell the kids from Heritage Hills the mid-range game is a thing of the past.
No.
They got pretty good looks from there.
I like how they play. I really like their team. Like, gosh darn, if they would have shot the ball a little bit better, they would have beat Silver Creek, lost in overtime in our morning game.
And Silver Creek awaits Lawrence Central. Coming up at the conclusion of this one, little push shot from Beaver is good. His first point since halftime. Well, the offensive prowess has been on display for each of these two teams. And
Broncos staying in the 1-3-1 here.
Almost a turnover. Will be a turnover.
And one. And one. Wow. Barnheiser. Great hustle play by Brooks Barnheiser after the deflection to find his brother, Braxton. And Braxton's really having a good third quarter here, Greg.
16 points in this game for Braxton Barnheiser.
Look at the hustle play. And found him. Strong with the ball. Yeah, the 1-3-1's really changed the tempo of this game right now and caused Heritage Hills to get out of whack here on offense.
But a missed free throw for Braxton. He's a 68% shooter on the season. The lead has expanded to 8 for Jeff. It was 10 in the first half for Heritage Hills. And a eventual, perhaps, maybe, turnover, yes. Finally, Jeff out of there with it.
And they're going to take one shot, unless Heritage Hills picks up the pressure, which doesn't seem like they're going to here. Again, only 4 fouls here in this third quarter. 3 by the Patriots.
It was a 25-point first quarter for Heritage Hills. 22 on the board this quarter for Lafayette Jeff. Just enough to break the 5-second count for Barnheiser.
Two-man game, brother to brother.
At 3-2, Williams has to go up. Did a good job to get around Sisley, but could not get the basket to go.
6 foot against 6'9", that was a tough matchup for Williams.
Lafayette Jeff, an 8-point lead, going to the fourth quarter of this consolation game at the Hall of Fame Classic on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
I'm working every day, 40 hours a week minimum. I make great money for a 20-year-old, I think.
I'm also a single mom to a 5-year-old toddler. Thanks to my union and my union career that I have amazing benefits for her.
You do something you feel good about every day and something you can have pride in.
Your full benefits, it's not just for yourself, it's for your family.
I've already got a job and no debt and making pretty good money.
Sometimes college just isn't for everyone just like me.
Your path to a great career begins at Ivy Tech Community College. Ivy Tech provides you with the education you need to jumpstart your career, sometimes in less than a year, for a high-wage, high-demand job. Whether you're looking to earn an associate degree, gain a new credential, or take a more affordable route to a bachelor's degree, Ivy Tech has what you need. With more than 40 locations and online, we are here to help you get started. Stop by a location or visit ivytech.edu to jumpstart your career.
Oh, baby, that got me awake.
The worm has turned in Logan Sport. Look at that play.
The lob underneath, and if you don't get any picture perfect more than that.
That young man will be glad that our cameras were here for tonight's contest. Both these teams, their final quarter of a doubleheader today here in Newcastle. Greg Rakestraw, Pete Smith with you on the IHSAA Champions Network. Thank you to those watching on MyIndy TV, Comcast 81, and the ISC Sports Network. Johnson, the lefty runner. Not that time. Great tip by Becker that would not go. And Beaver, I think, inadvertently got...
Ashton got popped in the nose there.
Yep, he'll be all right. Saw Dre Davis take a shot to the face earlier today. He's got 5 stitches because of that. Barnheiser, first time no, second time yes.
Biggest lead of the game for the Broncos now at 62-52. And staying in that 1-3-1 that got them going there, middle of the third quarter.
Sherry's break was brief. He'll check back in next dead ball for the Patriots. Becker had it knocked away. Barnheiser tips it to his brother. And from 25, Braxton couldn't get it to go. It is the ultimate green light. And now a timeout's going to be taken by Heritage Hills. It is a 30-second timeout. Today's game presented in part by SozoU Natural Health. SozoU dedicated to providing natural health consultations, products, and services to their clients. It's their mission to equip their clients with natural health options to help them achieve their health goals. Located in Crawfordsville, like them on Facebook or find out more information at SozoU.com.
Chris Kaufman there in the background behind those cheerleaders. Representing the IHSAA today.
Had a chance to talk to Chris briefly at halftime. Stats. How about this stat for Lafayette Jeff? They went 9 of 10 from the floor in the third quarter.
Had a good mixture of layups and a few threes, but really picked it up defensively when they went to the 1-3-1. Right now, that's been the game saver for them to build this 10-point lead here with 7:04 to go.
Starting five back on the floor now for the Heritage Hills Patriots.
Got to remember, Lafayette Jeff played the second game, so they have the shorter turnaround of playing. On the other side of that, Heritage Hills had a heck of an overtime game in the morning game earlier.
Becker for three. Got it. Becker with 13. That's his first point since halftime. 31% three-point shooting outfit, this Heritage Hills team. Beaver, the left hand, and score.
Oh, Ashton, nice. Saw the clear drive and went with his left all the way.
He's got 10.
Still going to stay in the 1-3-1. I'd like to get the ball down the baseline on this personally, and then get the overload. Right now they're just playing on that perimeter. It hadn't been too good for him.
Inside out.
Short.
But Becker waiting on it. That ball had no carom to it. It was so far off. Barnheiser, scoop and score.
Yeah, good clear out there.
And that ball, a turnover, a violation against Heritage Hills.
Well, I tell you, Braxton plays with so much passion. He's having a whale of a game here this second half.
15th Heritage Hills turnover.
Uncharacteristic of the Patriots. And how many today in the first game?
Seven. Ball poked away by Sherry. 11 giveaways for Lafayette Jeff. Becker, not there. And we're not seeing Heritage Hills. And again, you understand fatigue is a factor, but not making the difference in the offensive glass that did in the morning game against Silver Creek.
No, I don't want to say outplayed Silver Creek, but they really played, matched, if not harder. They were played just as hard, and that kept them in the ball game despite poor shooting. This game, not shooting the ball very well, and have more turnovers. Wasn't that one of the keys of the game? Who turns the ball over more times? Right now, it's Heritage Hills, and it's cost them. A little flex action by Jeff.
Williams in for Jones.
Out of it now. Too long a pass. There we go. Yep, just straight flex.
Beaver from the free throw line. Good look that wouldn't go. And Sherry out of there with it.
Sicily deep.
Trailer three for the big fella. His spot has been the top of the key, not necessarily that wing. And Sicily has just 2 points since halftime. Points have been more of a premium for Heritage Hills. Again, you can understand if the legs are starting to go. About 19 points since the break.
Yeah, I think Jeff's just going to really be patient. They got a good look last time, and I think Coach Barnheiser is going to talk to him about that.
And it will be a full timeout taken by Jeff, which means we will step aside. 4:30 left to play in this one. Jeff leads by 9, the Hall of Fame Classic on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Here's Oladipo for the lead.
To all the Pacers fans in the stands, you are who we play for.
You make us jump a little higher.
Dig a little deeper.
What a block by Turner.
It really is.
And play a little harder.
Boom, baby!
We're better because you show up to every game.
And together, we grow basketball here.
For ticket packages and more, go to Pacers.com/tickets.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you. Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
9-point game with 4.5 minutes left to go. The consolation game of the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic on the IHSAA Champions Network. Jeff had not lost before. Today they're trying to avoid two in the same day. Heritage Hills dropped one a couple of weeks ago to Brownsburg in this effort to bump up their schedule.
1-3-1 now by Heritage Hills after the timeout.
Barnheiser almost a traveling violation. Beaver for three. And Becker corrals the rebound. And Barnheiser makes the diving effort.
Good, Braxton. Crashed into our bench here.
And, of course, the production crew much more worried about the equipment than us. Both are fine.
Yes. Cody, you're all right. You're all right. Again, 1-3-1 by both teams now. Just trying to see if how sloppy they're getting on offense, just trying to force turnovers and make them take some bad shots.
Sisley powers his way up and in.
That is a good shot. That's what I was talking about, Greg, a couple possessions ago. If you get it on the baseline on the 1-3-1 trap like that, you can high-low it, and then it splits it. So you see, he's on the baseline. You can't tell, but there's someone in the high post there also. There you see the high post guy. And it's tough to guard. The problem is getting the ball down to the baseline and getting the proper spacing. That time, Heritage Hills found it.
So Sisley, first free throw of the game for Heritage Hills. Does not get it. First free throw with 3:50 left to play. It's been that type of game, a very low foul game.
That
deep
is deep.
Three. No.
That is really deep.
In the gym range for Barnheiser.
7-point lead with 3.5 to go. Not sure they really need that right now. But
steal.
He makes it up. That's the thing about this kid. He'll take a shot that's probably ill-advised, but then he'll come out and he'll make it up defensively.
When you hustle that hard, you're given more liberties offensively.
Well, yes. And again, the 1-3-1's been very effective. It's just kind of taking the flow out of Heritage Hills. Got such great shots that first quarter and first half.
So Williams commits the foul. It'll be his third, and that will also lead us to our final media timeout. 3:02 left to play in this one. 9-point lead for Lafayette Jeff. Back in a moment. Consolation game of the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
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 Kevin. Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
The only way to get better is to challenge yourself. And that's what we're doing at Xfinity. We are challenging ourselves to improve every aspect of your experience. And this includes our commitment to being on time, every time. That's why if we're ever late for an appointment, we'll credit your account $20. It's our promise to you. We're doing everything we can to give you the best experience possible. Because we should fit into your life, not the other way around.
This is really tough for me because I'm trying to remain professional on the show.
And then you got 50 feet of crap and the New York Knicks. You're 60, so I'm not going to put my hands on you, but I'm going to slap this guy instead.
Are we going to have our first real good argument on this show?
That's what everyone wants to hear.
And that is the point.
Oh, my God.
We are ripping fast today.
And how hard can it be, right?
These are now selling for about $3,500. So we're back to our old ways of pulling rocks.
Act like idiots on camera, open cards, and talk about the hobby.
Final 3 minutes and 2 seconds of tonight's game. Third place game here at the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. Heritage Hills led by as many as 10 in the first half. It was tied at halftime. Jeffs had the better of it in the second half and forced another Heritage Hills turnover.
Brooks read that the whole way. Brooks Barnheiser jumped the passing lane on the switch.
And you wonder if you might see more of this 1-3-1 zone going forward for Jeff. As Beaver connects his first three here in the half.
Well, it negates the fact they don't have a postman in there. I mean, I'm not saying Williams isn't a postman, but he's an undersized 6-foot postman against Sisley.
Sigler for three, not there. Beaver. Look ahead pass to Barnheiser. And Barnheiser cashes in.
But it's certainly been the biggest change of the game. With about 3.5 minutes to go, they went to the 1-3-1 Lafayette Jeff did. And it's just really completely taken Heritage Hills out of any kind of flow. They're struggling just getting the ball, breaking the 10-second mark.
And it got late early as Sisley is there to put it up and in. But all of a sudden, it's 2:05 to play. It's a 12-point game.
Yeah, and Heritage Hills obviously doesn't think they can press them full court because they're coming back in a half-court trap also.
But then Barnheiser just lost the handle. And Sisley, little step through and score. He's got 24 points in both games today.
Don't change that channel. I know it's a 10-point spread, but anything could happen when you've got two teams that have played a game earlier in the morning that are playing rather fatigued.
The full timeout taken by Heritage Hills. We'll keep it right here. Let's tell you about the IHSAA Foundation. Better educated coaches produce better athletes. You can help give high school coaches the training they need by contributing to the IHSAA Foundation. Make your tax-free contribution today at IHSAAFoundation.org.
So long pass there you see Simon Sherry made to Sisley, the first one. Then Sisley with a steal here. Not really a forced turnover, just a little bit sloppy. And again, as I mentioned going into your promo on the IHSA Foundation, getting a little bit fatigued and sloppy. Just not catching the ball with two hands there. And coming out of the timeout, Brooks Barnheiser just looked at me and shook his head like, yeah, that was sloppy. I think he heard me saying it. But we'll see what kind of pressure they come out with the timeout. Minute 51 to go here in regulation. 10-point lead for the Broncos.
Had a chance to go to the Hall of Fame Museum next door in between sessions.
But you went to Mancino's.
There was time for both.
No, okay. Okay, 1-2-1, 1-2-2 full court trap now this time looks like. Can let the inbounds pass come in and trap. Quick reversal.
And all of a sudden it's 3-v-1. But
yep, force the turnover, fool's gold.
And then Barnheiser hustles back.
Boy, Brooks has, I can see why Butler likes him so much, offered him a scholarship. He's so long, only a junior. When I say long, his wingspan is just tremendous. He's hard to pass around. But at the same time, good job by Heritage Hills going to some full court pressure. And though it was a 3-on-1, you've got to get the defensive player to guard you before he can make that pass.
Sherry, the runner, does not go. Barnheiser able to knock that rebound towards Beaver. 90 seconds left to play. By the way, if you want to foul to send Jeff the line, you've got to commit 3 more fouls after that one.
After that one, yes.
To get them to the line as Sisley is whistled. There have been 11 total fouls called in this game.
And it's been a very well-officiated game. It's just both teams have been taking jump shots, getting layups. The intensity of the defense level is not as high as we saw in the morning games by any means.
Backdoor cut, Beaver. Kicks it out. Avery lets fire. It's a good shot if it goes down. He's got 25. Yeah. And it's a 13-point game with 70 seconds left to go. So it certainly appears Heritage Hills is going to finish their day 0-2. As Sherry gets that one to go. First three that he has made since the opening stages of the game. Another full timeout. One more time. We'll keep it right here. Reminder, today's game is being broadcast on the ISC Sports Network. Catch live games, original programming, studio shows, and much, much more on the ISC Sports Network. Find us on the web, download the app, or see us on TV all across Indiana, including on MyIndy TV all of next year. The ISC Sports Network, local, lives here. So to finish that thought again, barring a 10-point comeback in 59 seconds, Heritage Hills is going to go 0-2 here today, but what does this program get from playing this level of competition they can apply come postseason time?
They can't match these two games today. They played much better this morning. They just didn't shoot the ball very well. That's the high point. It's tough to play a second game in two games in a day, I should say, a second game when you've already played one and it's a consolation game. This Jeff team is hard to defend because they can shoot from the perimeter so well. And especially when you put Jones in there, when Matt Jones is healthy, which he's played very limited minutes in the second half because of his bad wheel he's got, they're not going to see two teams like this on their schedule for the rest of the year. They're going to play some good teams, don't get me wrong, but, you know, a couple losses here, nothing wrong with that. They still have some time here. Let's see what this interesting out-of-bounds set. Someone's going to go long. I don't know who it's going to be. Well, it was Braxton, but he kind of got bumped. And now they should have a run out.
They're going to try to play keep away as best they can. And then Barnheiser is fouled. That'll be Kratzer that commits the foul.
But again, right now, Greg, this is a very valuable time for them also because they don't get down and are behind very much like this. Sometimes you have to make comebacks in a situation like this. So they're going to learn, do we trap on this? When do we foul? I mean, it's a good learning minute for them right now, despite the loss.
And there's a turnover.
And there is still 44 seconds left, and the way that some of these kids can shoot, you've got the school record holder, three-point shooter, and Simon Sherry out there. Becker's going to take this one, it looks like. He should just drive. It's a four-possession game.
Tough shot that doesn't go. Braxton Barnheiser's solid all-around game continues.
And that's going to be a foul. I wasn't sure if he tied him up before he got his arm or not.
Just the 16 foul, so we're going to have to foul one more time. If they're looking to foul to extend this game to the free throw line, Sherry gets whistled for the foul. And now a timeout has been taken by Lafayette Jeff. Again, we will keep it right here with 33 seconds left to go. In our second game coming up, 30-second timeout, been changed to a 30, by the way.
You know, you don't see too many teams that start two brothers like they're doing here tonight. we haven't really mentioned that too much tonight, but with the Beaver brothers and the Barnheiser brothers, not a lot of depth either. They went, seven guys tonight in this night game. That's pretty impressive to play as well as they did in the second half. They were, as you mentioned, 9 of 10 shooting in the third quarter.
Heritage Hills will play at Evansville Memorial. Matchup of two teams that made the football state championship game 4 weeks ago.
Big team. I saw Memorial play earlier this year against Evansville Wrights the night before the tip-off classic or the forum tip-off that you and I got to work. And they've got a good team. They're big.
Williams, the intended target. Sisley got in the way. By the way, Lafayette Jeff, they are also off until Saturday. They will head north to play at LaPorte Saturday afternoon in a 4:30 tip-off.
Different time zone. How about that? Slicers. Tommy Wells having a really good season. I think they're 6-7-1 right now, the Slicers are.
Beaver, Barnheiser, basket and ball game. Barnheiser now with 18 after having 30 in the morning session. Three in the corner, good by Kratzer. His first points of this game. 30-second timeout called by Heritage Hills. There's 16 seconds left to go.
Yep, 9-point spread here. Utah used to coach. I don't stop until that buzzer. You know, a quick steal here, another three. I think they're out of timeouts, though. I think Heritage Hills. Oh, they do still have one?
Okay. I believe they've got one timeout remaining. I'm just amazed you're sitting on a padded chair and no longer a bucket.
Up there, they're calling the dogs off. Here comes some multiple substitutions for the Patriots.
They're going to make sure they get everybody into the game, have a chance to say they played in this event for Heritage Hills. Aiden Susanara is into the contest. Logan Krakowski, who played earlier today. Alex Schaefer into the game as well for Heritage Hills. And Adam Guth, who played briefly in the first half, also has entered. So if you made the trip and you're in uniform, you get to play. So they will not foul anymore, at least intentionally, you would think. They will. Well, they're going to.
Well, they did.
Yep. Ooh. So free throws coming up here. Bonus opportunity for Braxton Barnheiser.
Phyllis couldn't see that full court toss there by Braxton. Got pretty close, actually, being a three-quarter court shot.
And at the conclusion of this game, give us about 25 minutes, and we'll have the tip-off of the championship game featuring Silver Creek and Lawrence Central. Barnheiser a miss. Ball makes its way to Krakowski. No good. Barnheiser, the rebound. No fouls for Heritage Hills. This game is over. Lafayette Jeff at their average in terms of points on the season at 78. They get a split of the day's festivities in Newcastle as they beat Heritage Hills by a score of 78-69. Post-game show comes your way next. You're watching the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic here on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
You know, sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think, Maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
I chose Marin University. I feel like this is a place where I could excel academically.
The smaller class size has always been important to me.
You're going to get to interact with real business people.
With our first course, you're already starting and running a business.
The education department was really excellent.
The nursing program was really great for me.
The faculty in the theology department, they care about whether or not you're doing well because they know that ultimately they're giving you the core of what it is your faith is built around, and your faith grows all that much more.
I'm working every day, 40 hours a week minimum. I make great money for a 20-year-old, I think.
I'm also a single mom to a 5-year-old toddler. Thanks to my union and my union career that I have amazing benefits for her.
You do something you feel good about every day and something you can have pride in.
Your full benefits, it's not just for yourself, it's for your family.
I've already got a job and no debt and making pretty good money.
Sometimes college just isn't for everyone just like me.
Game three of the day is in the books here at the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic in Newcastle. Lafayette Jeff from 10 down in the second quarter. They come back. They lead most of the way in the second half. They close it out with a 78-69 victory over Heritage Hills. Greg Rakestraw, Pete Smith with you. Coach, your final thoughts on this one?
Well, it was a game that had its back and forth for a while, but the big difference was in that third quarter, Lafayette Jeff picked up the defensive intensity by going to a 1-3-1. And Heritage Hills, I think the fatigue a little bit, got a little bit sloppy, had a lot of empty possessions, way more turnovers than they had in the morning game. And Jeff fed off that, particularly Braxton Barnheiser. He just played a super second half, other than missing a couple free throws, maybe taking one shot about 35 feet. That was a there was no shot clock. He didn't really need it, but like I said, he did some great stuff today.
The big three were just that for Lafayette Jeff. Avery Beaver, 25. Braxton Barnheiser, 20. Brooks Barnheiser, 18, to deliver Jeff their eighth victory of the season. We'll take this quick timeout. We'll come back and wrap up game number one from Newcastle and then get you ready for game number two, the championship game, that being Lawrence Central and Silver Creek. Back in a moment as you're watching on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Answer by Lafayette.
Takes home the victory.
Taking down the record.
Throws it deep. He's got a man and it's taking it.
Trying to find a lane. Walker has hit his second home run of the tournament.
And it's going to be a touchdown.
Oh, baby. That got me awake.
The worm has turned in Logan Sport. Look at that play.
The lob underneath, and if you don't get any picture perfect more than that.
That young man will be glad that our cameras were here for tonight's contest. There's a whole new way to watch high school basketball in the state of Indiana this year, as the Metropolitan Interscholastic Conference can now be seen on the ISC Sports Network. The ISC Sports Network, seen across the state of Indiana and with a new over-the-air broadcast partner in Indianapolis in MyIndy TV 23. See the best boys and girls matchups all season long and into the postseason. For more details, log on to iscsportsnetwork.com. Game three of the day is in the books. Game four, about 20 minutes away from getting started, that being the championship game at the Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic. Our coverage on the IHSAA Champions Network is presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance. Stop knocking on wood. By Raymond James, life well planned. And by Encore, don't think senior living, think senior lifestyle. Find out how we are different at liveencore.com. Scoring in this game for Heritage Hills, Sisley with 24, 15 for Murray Becker, 13 for Jake Johnson, 10 for Simon Sherry. Again, both these teams are now off until next Saturday when they resume regular season play. That'll do it for game number one here in Newcastle. Once again, the final score, Lafayette Jeff 78 and Heritage Hills 69. Pete Smith and I are back in about 15 minutes or so to get you ready for the championship contest between Silver Creek and Lawrence Central. Be sure to join us then. On behalf of our entire ISC Sports Network and IHSAA Champions Network crew, thank you so much for watching the 2019 Raymond James Hall of Fame Classic from Newcastle, the finest and largest high school field house in the world. More coverage comes your way next on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.